the sperm that could become men may be particularly vulnerable to Good afternoon, friends. I hope your day is going excellently. In this video, we're going to discuss a fascinating recent paper that shows us some real evidence that damage to men's testicles can directly cause them to have less boys when they try to have children. But before we do, please subscribe to the channel if you're not already, like the video, and comment on the video to help with the algorithm. Now let's get started. First of all, as longtime subscribers will know, I'm interested in what's called the sex ratio. That is the ratio of humans having either men or women. This ratio surprisingly changes and is determined by a number of factors which we won't exhaustively review in this video. Nonetheless, I'm very interested in determinants of the sex ratio, and in particular the reason I developed this interest originally was because of the observation that is well known in the performance enhancing drug community that performance enhancing drug users, particularly users of androgens, seem to have more girls later in life. A glaring example of this is the former Mr. Olympia Ronnie Coleman, who had a number of children while competing for the Mr. Olympia, all girls, all in a row. But there's another reason that the paper we're about to review is particularly interesting to me. As you guys know from my video on the innumeracy of doctors and all my trials and tribulations trying to deal with doctors during my own life for my own health issues, I am particularly frustrated by doctors' extreme confidence and lack of often expertise in the subject they're discussing. This paper will exhibit that unusual combination once again. In fact, I've even argued with medical professionals about the subject we're about to discuss, the impact of radiation on our health. Particularly when I've been exposed to radiation for medical treatments, for example, for an x-ray or so on, I tend naturally to ask the person working there if they're concerned about the exposure to radiation themselves. Even when I discuss it with them at greater length and point out that there should be cause for concern, even if the radiation exposure is within certain limits, they often are very nonchalant about it. Both medical doctors and radiologists and technicians I've experienced throughout my life seem extremely careless about the dangers of radiation exposure. In this video, we're going to find out that they're careless for absolutely no reason. First of all, medical professionals are exposed to radiation in their workplaces, but the radiation is limited to limits that are extrapolated from studies on Japanese survivors of the atomic bombings. Also, among medical professionals, radiologists and surgeons are most exposed to radiation at the workplace. Now, environmental exposure to radiation among medical professionals has already been associated strongly with cataract development, with thyroid disease, including varieties of thyroid disease such as hypothyroidism, as well as thyroid cancers, and cancers of many kinds. And it's thought to be that the cancer incidence that's greater among medical professionals is due directly to radiation damaging their DNA. Remember, all of this is happening within the limits set by governmental standards extrapolated from the bombings of Japan. So this radiation exposure to medical professionals is harmful to their healths. But does it affect their sex ratios, the ratios of their offspring being male or female? It does. Again, this effect was first noted decades ago in studies of the survivors of the atomic bombing of Japan. By 1997, orthopedic surgeons were shown to have altered sex ratios, and radiologists were shown to have altered sex ratios shortly after. And in 2013, cardiologists were shown to have altered sex ratios according to their exposure to radiation. But interestingly, in younger cardiologists below the age of 37, this effect was to reduce their potential to have sons, boys. On the other hand, when they were over the age of 37, the effect seems to be reversed, where they have more boys than they would have had otherwise. And finally, this takes us to our 2021 paper, which we wanted to review here. This paper studied exposure of radiation to the testes among orthopedic surgeons. Because of the power of lead to protect the surgeons from exposure, it was determined according to what kind of lead and what kind of devices they were using, whether their testes were directly blocked by lead clothing they were wearing. So in this manner, it was determined that orthopedic surgeons that had their testes exposed to environmentally acceptable levels of radiation, in particular, had altered sex ratios, where these orthopedic surgeons had less boys according to the exposure of their testes to radiation. Now, just to point out why this is so fascinating. First of all, the levels of exposure that medical professionals get, which they think doesn't harm them, not only harms them, but affects their offspring. Second, the damage directly to the testicles, direct damage there and potentially DNA damage, has a direct impact on sex ratios of offspring, which means that damage to the testicles may alter offspring sex ratios. Why this is interesting is because post-mortem studies of bodybuilders who use performance-enhancing drugs show that their testicles have unusual amounts of fibrotic tissue, like scar tissue, indicating usually damage in the area before the scar tissue was deposited. So it's likely the case that bodybuilders have had particular damage to their testes as they use performance-enhancing drugs like androgens. And this, just the damage itself, may be causal in their altered sex ratios. So how might this be happening? How could radiation exposure to the testes cause these surgeons to have less boys? Well, first of all, it could be that Y chromosome-bearing sperm that carry the Y chromosome that's unique to males, may be more vulnerable to damage from various sources, including radiation, which in turn may make them less viable as sperm to fertilize an egg, therefore increasing the ratio of X chromosome bearing sperm in the testes of men. Actually, that's not very precise. I should make clear that the damage may not only alter the ratio of Y chromosome bearing sperm in the male's testes, but also alter the ratio after deposition of the semen, such that the Y chromosome bearing sperm may die sooner than other sperm. And there is evidence of this in animals. For example, in fact, there's a lot of evidence of this, but I'm just gonna give you a quick review here. In mice, it's been shown that stress hormone exposure to the mothers in development, and how that happens, by the way, in this case, is that more exposure of female rodents, mice specifically, to male rodents during development causes them to have more stress hormones like cortisol, glucocorticoids. The glucocorticoids in turn make these mothers have less male offspring. They have more female offspring. On the other hand, in dogs, exposure to toxins in development can induce female dogs to have more female offspring. In fact, there's a somewhat common theme in the animal research that indicates that Y chromosome bearing sperm seem to be more vulnerable to stress-induced death. Now, the second question is, why does this happen? Why would the Y chromosome be more vulnerable? Is there some advantage? Well, here's my thoughts. These are just my personal thoughts that I haven't read elsewhere. My thoughts are this: if there's a difficult environment for males to be born in, that may indicate that the human species isn't evolved or adapted for that environment. If you want quicker genetic variation in a population, having founder effects, meaning individuals that have a lot of children, like Chinggis Khan's descendants and so on, having founder effects is a way to rapidly change a population's character, its genetic character. For example, this is evidence in Iceland, where Iceland was founded by a limited number of families. So there's a lot of founder effects. When you have founder effects, you can cause massive genetic variation very quickly. So the idea here is this: if the environment is dangerous, or my idea, I don't know if anyone else is positive this, if the environment is difficult for sons to be born in, then having less sons born that mate with more women, polygamous sons, would cause the greatest genetic variation quickly. So basically what happens here is that when the environment is difficult, male sperm die easier than female sperm. So the ratio of women to men increases. And in that sense, men become capable at procreating with more than one woman. In all cases, men have intrasexual competition where they compete with other men to impregnate women. But in the case that there are fewer men in general, these individual men who are more competitive may have more children, thereby causing more quick and uniform genetic changes to the population. Anyway, friends, that's just my personal model of what might be going on. It could not only be wrong, but there could be better models offered by academics in the literature that I haven't encountered yet. To review what we learned today, first of all, the health risks of doctors' lifestyles are underestimated by themselves. Forget about their advice about your potential health risks. Second of all, workplace radiation in the medical community is actually harmful for the medical professionals, and they mostly don't know it. Third, Y chromosome bearing sperm, that is sperm that could become men, may be particularly vulnerable to stress-induced death and changes in their behavior, such that when you're living a bad lifestyle, you may be more likely to have girls in particular. Anyway, friends, I hope this was interesting for you or somewhat useful, and I look forward to seeing you again tomorrow morning.